हा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी यशोदानंदन व्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीर वन चारी यशोदानंदन व्रज जन रंजन यशोदानंदन व्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीर वन चारी यशोदानंदन जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी यशोदानंदन व्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीर वन चारी हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे राम हरे राम हरे 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 कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे कृष्णा कृष्णा हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 सचिनंदन गौर हरि सचिन गौर हरि जय राधे राधे श्याम श्याम जय राधे
श्री प्रभुपाद की। Tai Gaur Premanande. So thank you all for joining. We'll start our presentation with invocation prayers. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurum Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhanvitamscha हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधो दीन बंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि नमः वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे थैंक यू सो मच फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू स्पीक फ्रॉम भगवद गीता फॉर माय ओन प्यूरिफिकेशन सो एज आई वुड बेग द ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ ऑल द assembled devotees. Zoom in. I would like beg the blessings of all the assembled devotees, especially the senior devotees here, to give me the blessings so that I can speak something which is meaningful and applicable in all our devotional lives, and we can progress in our Krishna consciousness. Thank you so much. So today's verse is our 41st verse of the second chapter of Bhagavad Gita. So we'll just recite this verse responsively. So Nikki, I'm sorry, there are lots of prayers and lots of new terminologies. So just bear with us. We'll try to make it relevant. But this is just the initial, setting the scene sort of. So thank you. So we'll just recite the verse and you can respond after me. Vyavasayatmika buddhir
Vyavasayatmika buddhir
Ekeha kuru nandana
Ekeha kuru nandana
Bahu shakha hyanantascha
Bahu shakha hyanantascha
Buddhayo vyavasayinam
Buddhayo vyavasayinam
Vyavasayatmika buddhir
Vyavasayatmika buddhir
Ekeha kuru nandana
Ekeha kuru nandana
Bahu shakha yanantascha
Bahu shakha yanantascha
Buddhayo vyavasayinam
Buddhayo vyavasayinam
Vyavasayatmika buddhir
Vyavasayatmika buddhir
Ekeha kuru nandana
Ekeha kuru nandana
Bahu shakha yanantascha
Bahu shakha yanantascha
Buddhayo vyavasayinam
Buddhayo vyavasayinam
Prabhuji, please chant.
व्यवसायात्मिका बुद्धि एकेहा गुरुनंदना
बहुशाखा ही अनंताश्च
बुद्धयो व्यवसायिना
व्यवसायात्मिका बुद्धि एकेहा गुरुनंदना बहुशाखा ही अनंताश्च बुद्धयो व्यवसायिना
सॉरी गो अहेड माताजी
व्यवसायात्मिका बुद्धि एकेहा गुरुनंदना बहुशाखायनंताश्च बुद्धयो व्यवसायिना
वन मोर फ्रॉम माताजीज
व्यवसायात्मिका बुद्धि एकेहा गुरुनंदना बहुशाखा ही अनंताश्च बुद्धयो व्यवसायिना
synonyms व्यवसायात्मिका
resolute in Krishna consciousness
बुद्धि intelligence
एका only one
इह in this world
कुरुनंदना
O beloved child of the Kurus बहुशाखा
having various branches
he indeed
अनंताः unlimited
च also
बुद्धयः intelligence
अव्यवसायिनां
of those who are not in Krishna consciousness
Translation purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada Ki. Translation. Those who are on this path are resolute in purpose and their aim is one. O beloved child of the Kurus, the intelligence of those who are irresolute is many-branched. Purport. A strong faith that by Krishna consciousness one will be elevated to the highest perfection of life is called Vyavasayatmika intelligence. The Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Lila 22, chapter 22, text 62 states, Shraddha Shabde Vishwas Kahe Shudrida Nishchay Krishna Bhakti Kaile Sarva Karma Krita Hai. Faith means unflinching trust in something sublime. When one is engaged in the duties of Krishna consciousness, he need not act in relationship to the material world with obligations to family, traditions, with obligations to family traditions, humanity, or nationality. Fruitive activities are the engagements of one's reactions from past good or bad deeds. When one is awake in Krishna consciousness, he need no longer endeavor for good results in his activities. When one is situated in Krishna consciousness, all activities are on the absolute plane, for they are no longer subject to dualities like good and bad. The highest perfection of Krishna consciousness is renunciation of the material conception of life. Please mark this line. It's very, very important. Okay. This state is automatically achieved by progressive Krishna consciousness. The resolute purpose of a person in Krishna consciousness is based on knowledge. Vasudeva Sarvamiti Sa Mahatma Sudurlabha. A person in Krishna consciousness is the rare good soul who knows perfectly that Vasudeva or Krishna is the root of all manifested causes. As by watering the root of a tree, one automatically distributes water to the leaves and branches, so by acting in Krishna consciousness, one can render the highest service to everyone, namely self, family, society, country, humanity, etc. If Krishna is satisfied by one's actions, then everyone will be satisfied. Service in Krishna consciousness is, however, best practiced under the able guidance of a spiritual master who is a bona fide representative of Krishna, who knows the nature of the student and who can guide him to act in Krishna consciousness. As such, to be well versed in Krishna consciousness, one has to act firmly and obey the representative of Krishna. And one should accept the instruction of the bona fide spiritual master as one's mission in life. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur instructs us in his famous prayers for the spiritual master as follows. Yasya prasadat bhagavat prasado, yasya prasadan agati kutopi, dhyayanstuvam stasya yashastri sandhyam, vande guru shri charanarvindam. By satisfaction of the spiritual master, the Supreme Personality of Godhead becomes satisfied, and by not satisfying the spiritual master, there is no chance of being promoted to the plane of Krishna consciousness. I should therefore meditate and pray for his mercy 3 times a day and offer my respectful obeisances unto him, my spiritual master. The whole process, however, depends on perfect knowledge of the soul beyond the conception of the body, not theoretically, but practically. When there is no longer a chance for sense gratification manifested in fruitive activities, one who is not firmly fixed in mind is diverted by various types of fruitive acts. So there's a long purport, and there's lots of very, very important concepts and points that Srila Prabhupada is touching upon. And this is, believe it or not, is the reason why we are all sitting here. This verse and the purport given by Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur is the reason why we are sitting here. Can anyone tell me why? Anybody wants to take a guess? Yes, Prabhu. Yes, so anybody else wants to add to that, or you want to elaborate on that a little bit more?
Focusing on the many things of this material world and not focusing on the one thing.
No, the specific reason why we are all here, we have been able to sit here together, is this verse is the reason. Yes, Prabhu.
So, our dear Srila Prabhupada, he actually came Western world because of the instruction of the spiritual master. This particular verse is telling us about the Vyavasaya Atmika Buddhi. You know, means to follow the spiritual master's instruction. And he followed it, the two instructions he was given, and write the books in English. If that wasn't the instruction, he would not have read that verse. I mean, he would not have this verse here, and we would not have read this, and we would not have come here. So that's the whole kind
yes.
of seed over there.
So that's absolutely right, and we will come to that point a little bit later. And when Srila Prabhupada read the commentary by Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur on this particular verse, where he emphasized the following the instruction of spiritual master to be the paramount process or paramount importance, has to be given the paramount importance. And thereby, Srila Prabhupada just focused on the instructions of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur and decided that, like, you know, this is my mission of life, as Srila Prabhupada points out in the purport, that this is the mission of my life, this is what I'm going to do. And he gave all his energy, he gave all his focus on this particular, and then that's how he started the whole worldwide movement. So this is very, very important verse for all of us, and it's it's the dearmost verse for many ISKCON devotees, because it gives all of us the reason, the focus in our own spiritual life, that we become one pointed. So we'll go slowly, we are jumping way far ahead, but the translation, it's here it says, those who are on this path. So which path we are talking about?
Krishna consciousness.
Krishna consciousness. So where does this path come from? Like, you know, anybody wants to, like, today it's going to be interactive session. I haven't prepared much, so I need help. Verse number 39, right? So 239 is right here for us. So this verse is also very nice and important verse. Here, Buddhi Yoga. I wish I could. Yeah. Buddhi Yoga. So before, we don't want to go too much into the technicalities here, but basically Lord Krishna is continuing from this verse that he has explained the difference between body and soul in detail, and now he's going to start talking about Buddhi Yoga. So Buddhi Yoga means, Buddhi means intelligence, right? And Yoga means to connect. So when you connect with your intelligence, to who? To the Supreme Lord, that becomes Buddhi Yoga. And it's not just intellectual exercise. It's that's why Srila Prabhupada gives the purport to this verse, and it's a very long purport. But at the very end, he gives us very wonderful summary. I'm sorry. There we go. One should therefore understand that Buddhi Yoga means to work in Krishna consciousness in the full bliss and knowledge of devotional service. One who works for the satisfaction of the Lord only, however difficult such work may be, is working under the principles of Buddhi Yoga and finds himself always in transcendental bliss. By such transcendental engagement, one achieves all transcendental understanding automatically. By the grace of the Lord, and thus his liberation is complete in itself, without his making extraneous endeavors to acquire knowledge. So the main point Srila Prabhupada is making in the purport, as also given in the 10th chapter, text 10, right? Who wants to say that verse? Who can say that verse? Chapter 10, text 10. I'm just following in the footsteps of my older brother, so please bear with me. Yes, wonderful. Please say the whole verse. Very nice. So, Dadami Buddhi Yogam. Again, the Buddhi Yoga word comes again, right? So, our verse has this word. Vyavasayatmika Buddhir. So, one-pointed intelligence. So, Dadami Buddhi Yogam. Krishna says that I give them the intelligence by which they can come to me. Who does Krishna give that kind of intelligence? Tesham Satata Yuktana. So, those who are constantly engaged in my service, Bhajatam Preeti Purvakam, serving me with love and devotion, for them, I give them the intelligence by which they can connect with me. So this is very important. And then here in this our verse, Krishna says, Ekeha Kuru Nandana. Resolute in purpose and aim is one. So as soon as we say that, like, you know, Prabhu, this is Krishna consciousness is our only goal and we should only work for that, we sound fanatic, right? Like we... people think that, like, oh, this person has nothing else to do, so that's why he's saying this. But as such, this resolute in purpose, as Srila Prabhupada points out towards the end of the purport, is based on a strong foundation of knowledge. The knowledge that who we actually are. So that Lord Krishna explained in very detail that you are not this body, but you are a spirit soul. And if you are a spirit soul, you are eternal. And if you are eternal, then this particular life is just a blink of an eye, which is like, you know, in unlimited time. So all your focus should be on gaining that eternal relationship, which is lost and forgotten with the Supreme Lord. And that's why with that strong foundation of knowledge, one can become resolute in purpose. So without that strong foundation, everything becomes irrelevant. So that's why from text 11 to 30, that's like almost 20 verses are dedicated to the same topic. Over and over again, Lord Krishna focuses on explaining that you are not this body, you are a spirit soul. You are different from your body. And the body means not just the physical appearance, also your mind, your intelligence, and your false identity. As we identify ourselves as a man or from India, from a particular profession, particular background, so on and so forth. All these are temporary identities that we have acquired upon us. And to remove all these identities, to actually be established in our true identity as the servant of the Lord or the spirit soul, that is the basis of resolute determination. If that, so that's why Srila Prabhupada says that it's not just a matter of theory. It has to be practically experienced that you are not this body, but spirit soul. But we can start at the theory level, and then gradually by following the process rigidly, we can actually overcome that just the theory part and have the practical experience also. So this is very, very wonderful. And so when one is becoming resolute in purpose and determined in Krishna consciousness, then is he missing out on something? Or does he have to do something more? Like, you know, anybody wants to shed light on that part? Like, you know, as here in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Jai Shri Radha Shyam Sundar Nitai Sachinandan Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. So as Srila Prabhupada quotes in the Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Lila chapter 22 text 62, this is a very famous verse and very wonderful verse, that Shraddha Shabde Vishwas Kohe Shudrida Nishchay Krishna Bhakti Kaile Sarva Karma Krita Hai. So Krishna Bhakti Kaile, when you perform bhakti for Krishna, Sarva Karma, all your other activities Krita Hai, they are all already done. You don't have to make a separate endeavor for it. So that having that kind of conviction is called Shraddha. And our bhakti process begins with Shraddha, right? Srila Rupa Goswami explains in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Ado Shraddha, first thing is Shraddha. So that faith, even before that a person could develop the faith and then starts to associate with devotees. But actually that could happen simultaneously. When one associates with a devotee, then one gains that kind of faith that yes, by performing devotional service to Krishna, we can actually take care of all our necessities and all the work that needs to be done. So that is confirmed in this verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, 11th canto, 5th chapter, text 41. Anybody? Any takers? actually, to remember the verse numbers are very difficult, but if I give you the first word, you want to complete the verse? Devarshi. I think I have to take your other style also. One person can only speak once. Because if one person, then it becomes like dialogue and everybody becomes spectator, right? So anyway, that's not nice.
Now onwards we'll take one-on-one, okay?
So this is Devarshi Bhuta Aptanrinam Pitrinam Nakim Karonayam Rini Charajan Sarvatmanaya Sharanam Sharanya. English, oh sorry. See, that's conditioning. Sorry, I can read Sanskrit, so I don't think of others. Sorry about that. So, Devarshi Bhutat Nirnam Pitrinam. We don't want to go too much into the details of the verse, but basically, as soon as we have taken birth, we become indebted to so many people, you know. So, but if we take shelter of Krishna, then all that indebtedness can be paid back. You know, the when like, you know, if we think of the like, you know, the struggles that our parents have taken for us, that we can only understand that when we have children ourselves. And I can say that for a fact for myself, that like, I never thought that raising children would be this difficult. So that kind of, you know, you can never pay back in any, whatever we may do, right? Like, you know, the debts that we collect from Deva, Rishi, people in general, Nrinam, okay, Pitrinam, all the king, or like, you know, any, everything that is being done for us, we can never pay back in full, no matter what we do. The only way to pay back everything is by becoming Sarvatmana Yah Sharanam Sharanya. So when we take full shelter of the Supreme Lord and serve the Lord with full heart, that's when we can pay back. That's the only way we can pay back. Just like Srila Prabhupada quoted this verse in the translation, in the purport, he just gave us the hint of this verse, that by watering the root, you nourish the whole tree. Who wants to take this verse? This is a popular verse. People should be able to do that. Yes, Prabhus. Anyone in the back? You are as enthusiastic as I am. Yes, please, Prabhus. Mataji's also, I'm not just saying Prabhus, but Prabhuji's and Mataji's. Yatha taror mool nishechane na tripyanti tat skanda bhujo pashakha prano pahara cha jathir yathendriyanam tathev sarva achutejyam. So, this verse is very nice also, that it basically explains that as we water the root, we don't have to separately endeavor to water each and every twig or branch or leaves of the tree. Similarly, just if we are hungry, we cannot, if our hand feels weak, cannot assimilate food on its own. It has to feed the stomach, and stomach can give the energy to the whole body. So just same way, Krishna, when served, takes care of all the other, because everything is within Krishna, everything is connected with Krishna. When Krishna is served, everybody else is served, everyone is served, incomplete. So this is our, this is the theory aspect.
You can make it smaller so you can accommodate more.
The translation?
I mean, yeah.
Yeah? Okay. So as pouring water on the root of a tree energizes the trunk, branches, twigs and everything else, and as supplying food to the stomach enlivens the senses and limbs of the body, simply worshipping the Supreme Personality of Godhead through devotional service automatically satisfies the demigods who are parts of that Supreme Personality of Godhead. So this is our theory. Now we get into the practice, right? The practice is how do we do it? How do we become Ekeha Kuru Nandana, right? One-pointed, resolute determination. How do we achieve that? So that can be achieved. Here Srila Prabhupada says, the resolute purpose of a person, service in Krishna consciousness is however best practiced under the able guidance of a spiritual master who is a bona fide representative of Krishna. So we have to follow the instructions of the spiritual master. There is no way around it. We have to, that's why the first limb in devotional service is Ado Guru Ashray, Guru Pada Ashray. That's our first thing. And by that means that, like, you know, it can be formal initiation, or it can also, for us, under the umbrella of ISKCON, coming in contact with Srila Prabhupada, reading his books, following his instructions in general, that can give us the entrance into the service in Krishna consciousness. So this is very, very important. As Srila Prabhupada mentions many, many times, that serving the spiritual master is our means to serve the Supreme Lord. As such, we cannot directly approach the Lord. We are very far removed. So, like, you know, for Srimad Bhagavatam, it is explained that, like, you know, it's the Nigama Kalpataror Galitam Phalam. So it's the ripened fruit, but it's high up on the tree. So there are devotees standing at each branch and bringing that fruit down for us. Similarly, if we want to go up also, we can only approach through spiritual master and parampara, guru parampara. That's why it's very, very important to be connected in guru parampara. And when we are connected in guru parampara, then we have the access to devotional service. So, like, you know, I'm not discouraging anyone who hasn't formally taken initiation. They are not left out. We are all in the same line. It's just the time is separating, like, you know, so eventually we will all be, and even at this very moment, we all have the opportunity to follow Srila Prabhupada's instructions. Srila Prabhupada has given it in his books. And after initiation, we are not going to do anything different. We are going to continue to do the same thing, but with more vigor and more focus, if we are not, like, you know, not doing it even at this point. So this is a very, very important aspect. And I actually wanted to end by 7:20, 7:25 at the latest. So I'm going to skip a few verses and tell you a beautiful story, and then that explains why this service to spiritual master is so important. So this story is from Sri Rangam, Sri Ramanujacharya, and the story is of when in Sri Rangam, Ramanujacharya was discussing Namma Alvar's Divya Prabandhas with his disciples. And one day, while discussing the glories of Lord Srinivasa in Tirupati, he started crying. So the disciples there started trying to figure out what made Ramanujacharya start shedding tears. Which verse was it? Which word was it? Why he was crying? And so they asked Acharya, Why are you crying? What made you cry? What is the deeper meaning behind the word that made you cry? And Ramanujacharya said, you know, because in Tirupati, Lord Srinivasa, he is not being worshipped properly. Right now he is being neglected. There is nobody there. He is high up on the hills and nobody is there to take care of him. I feel very bad for that. There are so many wonderful flowers growing on the hills of Tirupati, but there is nobody there to collect them and make garland for the Lord and offer it to him. So I want somebody to go there and do this service. Who amongst you are willing to go there to do this service? So Ramanujacharya asked them, and the disciples, the front rows started putting their head down, looking all around, thinking that, like, you know, how can we go there? Lord Ranganath is here. Our services to Lord Ranganath, and you know, even Ramanujacharya himself is here. So how can we leave his association and go someplace else? Everybody was thinking like that, but one student in the back rows, he got up and said, Guru Maharaj, I'll go. And as soon as he got up, his name was Anantasuri. So as soon as he got up, all the other disciples, they said, oh, no, you cannot go. You have a pregnant wife. You are so young. How can you take her with you? Like, you know, this is not right. Everybody started protesting like that. So Anantasuri said, if I don't go now and my wife delivers the child, then it will become even more hard. It will become harder to go with the child. So better we go now. We have some few months before the child is due. So we will go right now. So Ramanujacharya said, so when do you want to go? So the Anantasuri said, I'll go, if you tell me to go now, I'll go right now. And Ramanujacharya became so happy. He said, from now onwards, your name will be Ananta Alvar. And Ananta Alvar went to Tirupati. They went, like, you know, I went to Tirupati in a bus, but they at that time there was no bus to go up the hills, so they all had to take the steps. They went all the way up and started started doing their service. And while doing their service, there was like tons and tons of flowers to be collected and offered to the Lord. So Anantasuri, Anant Alvar now, he tried his best to do the service as best he could. But then he started thinking that right now it's monsoon season and the flowers are blooming nicely, so it will be fine. But in summer, there is nothing to, there will be no water to give these flowers and they will all wilt away. So I should maybe dig a pond so that in summer the flowers can be watered. So he, while the spare time that he had for from making garlands, he started digging a pond. And his wife would carry the dirt, like he would dig with the crowbar and fill up the bucket, and his wife would carry the bucket and throw it at a distant place. And that went on for a few days, and wife was pregnant, she's not supposed to do all this hard work, but sincerity of the devotees melted the heart of Lord Srinivas. And Lord came in the form of a hunter to help them. So when the wife was going to dump the dirt, the hunter came in and said, "Oh, you are a pregnant lady. You are not supposed to do this hard work." He snatched the bucket, ran and threw the dirt and brought back the bucket to her. And she brought her bucket back to her husband. And this time she came much faster than usual back and forth. So her husband asked, "How come you came back so fast? What happened?" So she said, there was a hunter who came and helped me. So her husband became surprised, like, how can somebody come and take our service, you know? So let me go talk to him. So he went and spoke to the hunter. "This is our service. This is our personal matter. Please don't come intervene in our service. Please go away." So the hunter went away, but then after a couple of times, he came back and did the same thing. And it went on for a few times. So Anant Alvar became very angry. Next time, he took his crowbar with him and started chasing that guy. And that guy was running away. So he threw the crowbar at him, which hit him on the chin and started bleeding. So actually, it's the Lord himself was in the form of a hunter. So he disappeared from there. And Anant Alvar, after finishing his digging seva, he went back to performing his garland seva. So now he's making his garlands. And the pujari in the temple was inspired by the Lord, saying that the Lord thought, like, you know, I want to tell him that, like, what he did to me. He threw the crowbar on my chin and hurt me. So I want to tell him. So the Lord told the pujari that, "Why don't you go fetch him? I want to see Anant Alvar right now." So pujari goes and calls Anant Alvar. Anant Alvar is busy making his garland. He says, "Not right now, my friend. You tell the Lord he has to wait." So pujari goes back and tells the Lord that he's not willing to come. He's doing his garland seva. So the Lord says, who is he making garland for? I don't care for the flowers if they wilt or whatever happens. Go call him right now." So pujari goes back, tells him that the Lord wants you right now. Please come. And he says, no, I'm not coming. I have to make this garland, then I'll come." And then Lord gets so angry. He says that if he doesn't come right now, I'll kick him out of the Tirupati. So pujari comes and tells the Lord is very angry. "You must come right now. Otherwise, he'll kick you out of Tirupati." So Anant Alvar says that, how can he kick me out of Tirupati? He came a few thousand years ago. I came a few days ago. We both are visitors here. How can one visitor kick out another visitor? I will only go out if my acharya tells me to go out. Otherwise, nobody can kick me out from here. And when Lord heard this answer from Anant Alvar, he became so pleased. And then after finishing up his garland, Anant Alvar brought the garland and offered it to the Lord, and thinking that the Lord is very angry, he didn't raise his eyes to see the Lord because the Lord must be very angry with him. So then when he was turning away and the Lord called him, you don't want to see me today? What's going on? And Anant Alvar turned back and saw there was a cut on the chin of the Lord, and it was bleeding. So he was like, oh my, he was so surprised, so aghast by that. And he thought like, you know, Ramanujacharya had sent me here to take care of the deity. Instead of taking care of the deity, I'm hurting the deity. What am I doing? He started repenting so profusely, and he thought like, you know, if there was a person, I could bring a doctor to do the needful. But here, the Supreme Lord, his aprakrita deha, what can I do for him? And he started praying to the Lord, my Lord, how can I make it right? How can I heal this cut? So the Lord said, please bring the dust of the devotee's lotus feet and mix it with camphor and apply it. So even till date, the same, the Lord Srinivas has a camphor applied on the chin, which is called as Shri Pada Renu. And that's how that is applied every day, even now. And that, so the point being made is that when one is resolute in determination in following the orders of the spiritual master, just like Srila Prabhupada was, I really have to speak about Srila Prabhupada, because without that, it's not fair, you know. So Srila Prabhupada, this is a issue of Krishna Kathamrita Bindu, and Krishna, I wish I can find it quickly. Okay, yes. So here Srila Prabhupada speaks that incident himself, which is very, very inspiring. Please pay attention and bear with me as I read. So Srila Prabhupada says, I'm starting to read from here. Right, everybody can see it. Yeah. So I was born in one family, and my Guru Maharaj was born in a different family. Who knew that I would come to his protection? Who knew that I would come to America? Who knew that you American boys would come to me? These are all Krishna's arrangements. We cannot understand how things are taking place. Today is the 9th of December 1968. 32 years ago in Bombay, I was doing business. Sometime between the 9th or 10th of December, my Guru Maharaj was a little indisposed, and he was staying at Jagannath Puri on the seashore. Jagannath Puri on the seashore. So I wrote him a letter. My dear master, your other disciples, brahmacharis and sannyasis, are rendering direct service to you. I am a householder. I cannot live with you. I cannot serve you nicely. How can I serve you? I was simply thinking, how can I serve him seriously? His reply was dated 13th December 1936. In that letter, he wrote, I am very glad to receive your letter. I think you should try to push on our movement in English. That will do good to you and to the people who will help you. That was his instruction. Then on the 31st December 1936, that means just a fortnight after writing this letter to me, he passed away. I took that order of my spiritual master very seriously, but I did not think that I will have to do anything particular thing. At that time I was a householder, but this is the arrangement of Krishna. If we strictly try to serve the order of the spiritual master, then Krishna will give us all facilities. That is the secret. I took his order a little seriously by studying a commentary by Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur on the Bhagavad Gita verse Vyavasayatmika Buddhir Ekeha Kurunandana. He says there that we should take up the words from the spiritual master as our life and soul. We should try to carry out the specific instruction of the spiritual master very rigidly, without caring for our personal benefit or loss. So I tried a little bit in that spirit, and he has given me all facilities to serve him. Now, in this old age, I have come to your country, and you are taking this movement seriously, trying to understand it. We have got some books now, so there is a little foothold for this movement. So on this occasion of my spiritual master's departure, as I am trying to execute his will, similarly, I also request you to execute the same order through my will. I am an old man. I can also pass away at any moment. That is nature's law. Nobody can check it. I appeal to you on this auspicious day of the departure of my Guru Maharaj is that you should try to push on this movement. People are suffering for want of this consciousness. Srila Prabhupada's lecture in 1968, December 9. So this is Srila Prabhupada's mood. This is what he came to give us. And if we follow Srila Prabhupada's instruction, at a very basic level, what my Guru Maharaj says to everyone in general is that we do four things. Chant the holy name attentively. Read Prabhupada's books, study Prabhupada's books submissively. Associate with devotees lovingly. And preach enthusiastically. So if we do four things, then Krishna will definitely reveal direct and personal service to us also through the mediums of devotees and spiritual master. But at least we should start with these four things. If we do these four things, then our life will be definitely successful. So I can elaborate a lot more on this, but in the interest of time, I will stop here. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna. The story is here on YouTube. So if you all, I hope it loads soon. But it's by Jeev Jago Media and it's Mahavishnu Prabhu describes it very, very nicely. So please watch it at your convenience. Thank you.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you so much for the wonderful class. I have a question. You mentioned that we should theoretically understand that we are a spirit soul, which we all do. I think intellectually we all know we are a spirit soul. But you also mentioned that we should practically experience it. So can you shed some light there? How to practically experience that we are a spirit soul? What are the do's there?
The do's are basically that we stick to the process, no matter external circumstances. Sometimes like when we are having favorable winds toward behind us and we are doing our sadhana nicely, we think that we are such a good devotee. But then when those favorable winds become opposing winds, oops, sorry. Yeah, that's better. Sorry about that. So when those favorable winds, instead of favorable, becomes opposite side wind, and then our boat starts to shake, then our sadhana starts to disappear in some ways also. So in that situation, if we persevere, if we push on, then that will become a practical experience that, okay, my mind is screaming here, my body is aching here, but I am not going to give up. I am going to go on. So that will enable us to experience practically when we immerse ourselves into our service, no matter our external situations, then it will. I mean, I'm speaking all theoretically. I haven't done that myself. So, if Ramchandra Prabhu can explain that better than me, but that's how we can practically understand.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Anyone else? Krishna Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Dhanavats. Wonderful class.
Thank you.
And very well presented. So I have a question here, like with regards to serving the spiritual master, right? So when you were reading that, it was mentioned that we should serve our spiritual master with full heart and do whatever is needed, like, so in, as we know, during the Treta Yuga,
yes.
Shabri, right?
Mm-hmm.
She served her spiritual master, Matanga Muni,
mm-hmm.
And the spiritual master was happy and he blessed her that one day Ram will come and personally come and right. bless her, right?
Right.
So my question here is one must serve fully and surrender fully and serve with full heart. So as per the Shastras, what is the definition, how do you define surrendered fully and wholeheartedly? Yeah, in this, how all in this yuga, Kali yes. Yuga, right? We are compared to Treta Yuga, we are most fallen here. So in this Kali Yuga, how one should
serve?
Sometimes we are not able to follow the instruction of our spiritual master. So how do we?
Yes, Prabhu, we are both in the same boat. But at the same time, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur explains that, in the commentary I was supposed to read, but I didn't get to read the commentary that Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur gave. He said that serving the order of spiritual master is my life and soul. And I will do this, whatever happens to the world, I don't care. With that focus and determination, I'm just going to give all my heart into the service of the Lord. So that surrender and submissiveness to the order of the spiritual master, it can manifest in many different ways. But basically, as I said, those four principles, the core principles of what Srila Prabhupada has given us, the holy name, books, association with devotees and preaching. Those four, if we just give our focus to those four, then that will be equivalent to our,
And regarding following the instructions of Guru, our spiritual master, so it is mentioned, you should follow the instructions. What if spiritual master gives us an instruction and it is beyond our capacity?
We should do our best. Whatever we can do, we should do our best. And my Guru Maharaj says there are three types of disciples. One disciple is knows the mood of the spiritual master and executes it without being told. The second class is that is told, please do this, and then he does it. And the third class is that no matter what you say, he does what he wants to do. So we should try to become at least second class, if not first class, but do the best we can. We are limited, we have our conditionings and whatnot may be, but we should do we should try our best and try to pray to Krishna. As Ayendra Prabhu would say that we should cry because we are not able to cry for Krishna. We should pray to the spiritual master and pray to the Lord that I want to follow the instruction, I want to do this, but I am not able to do this. Please help me do it. That's what I think.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, Rudy.
Just like to add to that.
The spiritual master knows our capacity. So it is us who feel that we don't have the capacity.
Yeah, it says that with the order comes the empowerment also. So when you are given a service, you are also given the empowerment to execute the service. So we have to have that faith in the spiritual master that he has given this order, so I must be able to do it also. Srila Prabhupada, if he had thought my Guru Maharaj told me to preach in the English language, and I'll write some books, and that would have been sufficient also. If he had just sat in Vrindavan and completed Bhagavatam in Vrindavan, that would have been immense service itself. Nobody would have said why didn't you go to US, right? But he took it in his heart that I have to do it by all means, and I want to do it by all means. So it depends on our willingness to take on. And yeah. Is that all? Thank you so much. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.